Greetings and salutations. Thank you for lending an ear to The Voice of the Times this Friday, January 2, 2021. For today's editorial, PSG case obliges government to remove barriers to vaccine access. The revelation earlier this week that members of the Presidential Security Group, or PSG, as well as some military and police personnel and a number of government officials, have already received the Sinopharm vaccine against COVID-19 took much of the public by surprise. However, it only confirmed rumors that have been swirling for days that some well-connected personalities have been able to obtain vaccines in spite of their not yet being available to the rest of the population. Now that the cat is out of the bag, so to speak, the government no longer has justification for maintaining any restrictions on access to vaccines and should remove the various barriers that are now in place. The controversy over the insider vaccinations is that the Sinopharm vaccine, or for that matter, none of the anticipated vaccines from various sources, has not been formally approved for use by our Food and Drug Administration, or FDA. This is significant because of recent stern reminders from the FDA, dutifully highlighted and passed on to the public by Malacanang, that the use of unauthorized vaccines is not permitted and not recommended. The news that the PSG personnel and others have already received inoculations certainly reinforced the impression that there is one set of rules for the elite and well-connected and a different, less compassionate set for the rest of us. Realizing this, some government figures initially tried to explain away the matter by pointing out that the law does not specifically prohibit use of unapproved medicines, only their distribution and sale. Realizing that the explanation struck most people as ridiculous, the story was changed again. Supposedly, the PSG and those who administered the vaccine had obtained a previously undisclosed emergency authorization from the FDA. Given the importance of the work of the people who protect the president and the nation, we do not question the worthiness of the PSG, the armed forces, or the Philippine National Police to receive the vaccine while others who need it are still waiting for theirs, even though it is assumed that some groups should have priority over others for the limited vaccine supplies. The unavoidable fact is that everyone needs the vaccine. Some people must rely on the government to supply it, but many do not, and have the means to obtain it if one is available. The fact that some have been vaccinated is undeniable evidence that at least one vaccine, China's Sinopharm, is already available in the country. And there will be very soon be others as well. For the government to insist that no one else, not medical workers, other essential workers in business, willing to purchase vaccines for their staff, clinics that can supply vaccines to customers quite willing to pay for them, can access them because the bureaucratic formalities of FDA approval have not yet been carried out, is inconsiderate and inhumane. While we understand that the FDA's position is based on a responsibility to protect the public from potentially harmful medicines, we strongly believe that the government should embrace the reality that there is nothing so clinically unique about the Philippine situation that the successful use of the various vaccines rolled out so far, Sinopharm, Sinovac, Pfizer, Moderna, AstraZeneca, and Sputnik V, by hundreds of thousands of people elsewhere, needs to be questioned at length. As long as the vaccine candidate meets the standards for efficacy set by the World Health Organization, has performed successfully in testing, and has been administered without serious complications anywhere in the world, it should already have the FDA's automatic approval. It is no fault of the government that we have had to wait for so long for vaccines that will finally end this miserable pandemic. They required time to develop and produce after all. Now that the work has been done, however, the blame for any further delay does fall squarely on the government. Allowing the broadest possible access to vaccines will only help ease the government's burden and costs in carrying out the national vaccination strategy as well. Compassion and practicality demand that it removes the roadblocks and let those who are able to obtain the long-awaited vaccines. And that's the editorial for Friday, January 2, 2021. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print, subscribe to our digital edition, or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, and listen to The Voice of the Times.